No, I'm playing as a different character right now.
Here we go now. Okay. As soon as we're done, you can find your old pocket. Or try to start a new one. You'll have money in your pocket to go to the store with. And there'll be chances to make more, if that's what you're after. And chances to raise hell, too, if you feel you're in the need of them. Okay. We haven't got far to go now. You still seem strong, though. I mean, it doesn't look like breaking all those rocks has left
you. Yeah, remember your wrong mask on the mic that we have to do. And the first thing you mean? Mm-hmm. I think so.
No shit.
Play this time. Huh? Then he plays his son. Okay, now Leroy yeah, the son's all fully grown up and looks just like him. What year is when the son is grown up? 1914.
Maybe you just want to put it all behind you to get you in there at all.
Right, but when World War I starts.
You see cars and stuff
like that? Yeah, you get to be, there's a mission where you're in a car, an armored car with a machine gun.
You owe her an audience, at least. You've been away for a while, so we'll help you get set up in the world. And if you want to accept our offer, you can. That's more than reasonable. You're free to run on the range to wait a few months longer. Okay? Good.
Wow.
Just up here. There's the camp. It's your horse. Come on.
Hitch up. Maybe that we went to jail.
Then the clerk, how did he do? What did you tell him?
Nothing, as we discussed.
Thank you.
Do you think he looked better than I have?
I do hope we haven't inconvenienced you dreadfully. But seeing as you were due to be hanged in a week, I'm sure you don't object too strongly. I know you're innocent. Well, not perhaps exactly innocent, but not guilty of what you were accused. I know you and those who were with you that died were little more than patsies. And that you were set up by one of three men or a woman, possibly by all of them. I can't be sure, but that is all I know so far.
And one of these people also made Mrs. Leclerc a widow.
And I will avenge my husband's death, so help me God. But I will not avenge it upon men who did not cause it, or caused it unwittingly. Anyway, I'm sure this is all a touch confusing and melodramatic. When the man is calling, please show our guests to their tent and give them some fresh clothes to put on.
Very good,
then serve us both a little refreshment.
Give us some hiding ice.
This way.
Yeah,
we'll find a change of clothes in there. Alongside a few other items you might need, a lasso, a knife, and a lantern, I believe.
Plantation here. I like my stuff a lot better. Oh yeah, I'm looking at it.
Apparently the steel of the pole.
The buckskin. Every day over. You didn't shirt?
I look like a poor guy.
He is poor. They just broke him out of jail. He has no money. Boots. I'm gonna put on my boots. There we go.
That looks more comfortable. Polly?
Here, madam.
Your very good health. I suppose it beats dying, hmm?
Mrs. Leclerc's husband was murdered by one of his business partners.
And I intend to find out which one. Or rather, I intend for you to find out. And kill them. You're the only person I could possibly trust to do whatever it takes. Because you and your accomplices, you're the only other victims of the guys still alive. See, you walked into the town at approximately the same time my husband was shot in the back, but by another gun, firing different bullets to those you possessed when you were arrested. These bullets, this was their mistake. You were rounded up and sentenced to death, all because you came to town and didn't talk too much and seemed like you were nasty. Anyway, here they are. The people who run Blackwater. Mr. Jeremiah Shaw, banker, real estate speculator, and crook. Mr. Amos Lansing, ranch owner, speculator, and crook. Mrs. Grace Lansing, his wife, society patroness, lover of the arts, crook, and my former best friend. Teddy Brown, her disgraced brother, outlaw, wanted man, still in contact with him. All I ask of you is your help in finding out quite what happened.
Mrs. Leclerc would like to help you get back on your feet. Back to work.
Whatever your work may be, I don't judge. You want to rob? Rob. You want to save innocent folk? Do that as well. But you need me just as much as I need you. I think we all understand each other.
I hope we do.
Good. I look forward to rewarding you for killing those who made me a widow. My husband was a true believer in this country and in the West. He was killed for greed. Foul greed, and that's quite enough for everybody. I don't care what your scruples are as to killing. I will take the full burden of that sin upon my shoulders. Goodbye, for now. Then Hawley, go introduce him to nice Mr. Cripps.
I think he'll like Cripps well enough. He's long past his prime, of course, but he hasn't gone entirely crazy just yet. And he will help you, better than most of his ilk. Cripps! Get up!
Hello, partner. Hawley?
This is your new boss.
Oh, pleased to meet you, partner. J.B. Cripps at your service.
We'll pay to get your camp established. Mrs. Leclerc is a generous benefactor.
And where are we heading?
Oh, sir. While Cripps is establishing your camp, perhaps you can go to the station and see the clerk. Then head to see Clay Davies. He's a horse thief and a terribly nice one. Then meet Cripps back at your camp.
See you shortly, boss.
Good luck.
hello. You must, you must be a Arlen's friend. He's one of us. He said you also were a discouraged man.
I'm very discouraged. Disappointed, Arlen. That's me. Anyway, it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.